Tonight, live from the Hampton Coliseum, it's the CAA final as the University of North Carolina Wilmington takes on the top-seeded Navy midshipmen. Tonight's game is brought to you by Stroh's and Stroh Light. Now you're talking good times, and Stroh's is spoken here. And by All-Stars, five locations with over 1,500 Chevrolets, Chryslers, Plymouths, and Dodges at super discounted prices. It'll be the top-seeded Navy against the University of North Carolina Wilmington Seahawks, the second-seeded tournament to decide the CAA champion. Hello, everybody. I'm Mel Proctor along with Kevin Grevey. Not only do we have the two top kings in the tournament, but we've got two of the best players, probably the two best in the conference, and two of the best ever to play from their respective schools. All-American David Robinson of Navy, Brian Rousham of the University of North Carolina at Wilmington. Of course, we all know about David Robinson, incredible athlete, Kevin.
Well, he really is, and in this tournament, he's shown so many things. He runs the court so extremely well, and those alley-oop dunks just brings the house down. He's an unbelievable athlete, one of the best I've ever seen, and he just seems to get better and better every game. Brian Rousham, he's the only player in the conference that can match up to David Robinson with size and strength, but still, he's going to be outmatched, and he's going to have to perform probably one of his best games for UNCW to have a chance.
UNCW has never beaten Navy. These two schools have met seven times. Navy has won all seven, including a win this year in North Carolina. David Robinson had a 17-foot shot at the buzzer to give Navy a 67-66 victory, and the Middies swept both games this year. Let's go now to the public address announcer, Bill Sullivan, for tonight's starting lineups.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome once again to the Hampton Coliseum for the 1987 Colonial Athletic Association Basketball Championship. Tonight's winner will advance to the NCAA's championship game. Tonight features the Seahawks of the University of North Carolina, Wilmington, and the midshipmen of the United States Naval Academy. The Seahawks have a record of 18 wins and 11 losses. The Middies come in at 25-5. Navy will be in white, though the home team, NC Wilmington, will be the visitor. They'll be in green. Here are your starting lineups. At one forward for the Seahawks, a 6'6 sophomore from Fremont, Ohio, Greg Bender. At forward for the midshipmen, a 6'7 sophomore from Burke, Virginia, Derek Turner. Also at forward for the Seahawks, a 6'6 senior from Spring Lake, North Carolina, Charles Cherry. And at forward for the midshipman, a 6'7 senior from Floyd's Knob, Indiana, Carl Ebert. At center for the Seahawks, a 6'9 senior from Columbia, North Carolina, Brian Rousham. For the midshipman, a 7-1 senior and National Player of the Year candidate from Woodbridge, Virginia, David Robinson. At guard for the Seahawks, a 6'2 junior from Anderson, Indiana, Mark Gary. At guard for the Middies, a 6'4 junior from Ellicott City, Maryland, Cliff Reese. Also at guard for the Seahawks, a 6'2 senior from Chapel Hill, North Carolina, Sandy Anderson. And at guard for the Middies, a 6'2 senior from Wheeling, West Virginia, Doug Wojcik. The Seahawks are coached by Robert McPherson. The Middies are coached by Pete Herman.
Pete Herman succeeding Paul Evans, who moved out of the University of Pittsburgh.
Robert McPherson succeeding the popular Mel Gibson, who's become an assistant athletic director at UNCW. The officials tonight, Hank Nichols, David Dodge, and Rusty Herring. Big matchup is in the middle with 6'9", Brian Rousham, the Seahawks' all-time leading scorer and rebounder, against the 7'1", David Robinson, who's Navy's all-time scorer and rebounder. And he has also moved into 13th spot on the all-time scoring list in NCAA history and could pass several other players tonight. Navy has won 12 in a row. They are 25-5. UNC Wilmington riding a three-game win streak. The Seahawks are 18-11. Navy advanced with wins over William & Mary and James Madison. And UNCW beat East Carolina in the opener on Rousham's three-pointer at the buzzer and had to come from behind, beat Richmond 69-63 yesterday. Number 50, David Robinson, averaging 27.7 points a game, fourth in the country in scoring and rebounding, and leads the nation in block shots. As we said earlier, Navy has won every game in this series.
Wilmington's going to have to play extremely well if they want to win this game.
And the Seahawks control the tip. 22 is Sandy Anderson, who scored a career-high 24 points yesterday. 31 is Charles Cherry, a banger on the boards. They go right into Rousham, but Robinson slaps it away. It's grabbed by Derek Turner. Nice. Robinson leads the team in steals.
He's going to be up for the challenge, I'm sure. David Robinson knows that Rousham is capable of having a good game.
Wide open jump shot, and he throws up an air ball.
Good start for the pitch fella. He is a good shooter from that range, but he wasn't able to draw anything on that one.
Greg Bender, 33, tries to make the entry pass to Rousham.
You notice they're taking the ball right to Rousham. Both times they've been trying to get David Robinson possibly in foul trouble.
Here's the 45-second clock. At least above the basket are not working as Robinson rejects one, but they have a clock down on the floor that are working. You don't see them, but they've got two smaller 45-second clocks on the floor, but those atop the backboard are not working.
Maybe in their typical 2-3 zone, they pack it in. They're going to have to also get David Robinson some help inside there.
Rousham taking it right to Robinson.
There he is. That's the game plan. UNCW is going to try to get the ball into Rousham. Try to draw some fouls on David.
That's a blocking foul on Sandy Anderson. His first foul.
Now Rochick's got his work cut out. Sandy Anderson is one of the top defensive players in the league.
Rousham, in two games against Navy this year, had 18 points in a career-high 19 rebounds in the first game. In the second game, 19 points, 11 rebounds. Cliff Reese is 44. Carl Liebert, 40, having a great tournament. He had 21 points yesterday. Rochick. Charles Cherry, Bender with the rebound. And a steal by Doug Rojic, and Anderson commits his second foul. Rojic picked and clean.
It's going to be a good matchup. Rojic, a gutsy ball player, here makes a terrific move. And there's a foul on Sandy Anderson. Sandy Anderson just a little careless with the ball.
He has two quick fouls the first minute and a half of the game.
He had his career high last game where he had 24 points.
Robinson swings it to Liebert. Really looking for his shots now. His confidence is very high.
Sure is. He's really played well in the tournament.
15, Mark Carey. Rousham turning out Robinson. Saved by Sandy Anderson. Gary's had shooting problems in this tournament. He's normally a very reliable outside shooter. Navy in a man-to-man. Rousham going right at Robinson. Gets a piece of this shot. That's out of bounds to Navy. Doug Wojcik from West Virginia. His family is here for the weekend tournament. They were out having dinner last night with Cliff Reese and his family. Robinson too strong off the glass. He's throwing up everything a little too hard in the early going. Anderson. Two Seahawks there. Rousham. And he's called for traveling. He's upset.
I think he's complaining that the ball was hit. He didn't lose possession of the ball, that he got hit on the hands.
It's still 2-0 NCW Wilmington. Both teams appear to be a little tight in the early going. Navy is 0-4 from the floor. Robinson still hasn't got one to drop, and Sherry, a big rebounder, has his fourth rebound already.
Both Robinson and Rousey are trying to do it all right now, and they're just not getting their games together. They're both attacking the basket.
Anderson penetrates and throws it back out to Bender. What Robinson will do, he'll chase you back outside.
Navy's in the man-to-man defense. I'm kind of surprised to see him start out like that. Normally, throughout most of the tournament, they've been playing a zone.
Rousem, a good shooter, following the miss, but Robinson tips it to Carl Lieber. Rousem has pretty decent range for a setter. About 15 to 18 feet is his range. Derek Turner over Jerry. Rousem with a rebound.
Well, no one can seem to find the basket. I think nerves are part of that. It's a championship game. You know that these guys are feeling a little bit jittery. They want to get this NCAA bid.
Robinson with a steal, taking it away from Rawson. Turner and Lieber to 2-on-1, but Derek Turner loses the handle. 2-0, UNC Wilmington. Brian Rawson has scored the only basket of the game. Wojcik with a three-pointer. Rebound Anderson has got Mark Gary on a breakaway at the other end. Reese tries to challenge him. Good head fake by Gary, and it's 4-0 in favor of the Seahawks.
Wojcik fell down on his shot. That's how that fast break developed.
Pounded inside to David Robinson. Still hasn't hit a shot. And Anderson finally up with a loose ball. On the pull-up, 6-0, UNC Wilmington.
Played that very well. Anderson's a good guard. An excellent shooter. He's averaging 10 points a game, but I think he's really underrated.
David Robinson is 0-for-4 so far, including an air ball and a wide-open jump shot. He also threw a brick off the backboard. He finally connects. Navy scores their first basket at the 15-15 mark. Took them 4 minutes and 45 seconds to score.
Pete Herman looks a little relieved over there. He finally sees the big guy get his hoop.
15 minutes remaining in the half. Rousem gets Robinson off his feet and a foul. It counts. Beautiful move by Brian Rousem. They want to get Robinson in foul trouble and get him out of the game.
That's really their only chance. Here he gets a nice head fake and gets Robinson off his feet. David Robinson loves to block shots, so he has a tendency sometimes to leave his feet. There just a little touch foul, but the referee was right on it and made the call.
Terry Manhurts is getting more and more playing time at the end of the season. He's in, replacing Derek Turner. Robinson charged with his first foul. Manhurts and Craig Crazy did a great job off the bench yesterday. Three-point play for Brian Rousem, who's outscored David Robinson 5-2 in the early going. And it's 9-2 UNC Wilmington. Back in a 2-3 zone. Rousem is following Robinson wherever he goes, and they force a turnover. Charles Cherry is up with it for the Seahawks.
Sammy Anderson showed his quick hands there with the steal.
Gary with a great save, and Cherry with another save. Gary went into the Navy bench for a save. 9-2 UNC Wilmington. Bender. Rousem moves outside. Navy's in a zone now. 2-3 zone. Gary with a good fake and a pull-up baseline jumper to make it 11-2.
Terrific start for UNCW. They have a lot of confidence. They're shooting the ball a little better. Navy's just got to get into some kind of flow. Try to get David Robinson the ball.
Robinson, surrounded by three men, scores anyway. David had 26 points in the first game against Worthy and Mary, 16 yesterday against James Madison. Although he played very little in the second half after picking up a pair of fouls. 7-point lead for the Seahawks. They will put up some three-pointers. Gary, Anderson, and Bender, all excellent three-point shooters. They've attempted nearly 300 three-pointers on the season. Shot clock down to 12 seconds. Rousem against Manhurts. tough angle. Rebound to Doug Wojcik of Navy. 13 minutes remaining in the first half. The quick entry pass to Manhurd.
Manhurd is playing well. Doug Wojcik got him the ball in a good position, and Manhurd just went up for the shot. He's really coming into his own here in the tournament.
The Seahawks lead cut to five as Anderson penetrates, but Green Bay would push from behind. Navy again in the zone. They came out of man-to-man, but they switched to zone defense now. Anderson, the three-pointer. Good block out by Carl Liebert. Wojcik pushes it up the floor. Reese. Reese Robinson wasn't expecting the pass. Underneath to Liebert. And who's going to claim it? Liebert says, I'll take it.
He has missed very few shots. He's really on fire. He had 21 points yesterday against James Madison. 16 in Navy's opening round win over William & Mary.
He's really finding his range. He likes to turn and shoot. Seahawks going to have to really guard him.
Oh, there's another steal by Robinson. Cherry trying to get back defensively. Look at the big man handle it. Wojcik. Maybe he's unable to convert off the steal.
They didn't handle that break at all well. As soon as Robinson got the ball, he should have given it to Wojcik, and Wojcik could have hit him back for an alley-oop.
Good point. 11-8, UNC Wilmington. Trying to feed Rossum, the ball is kicked, so a new 45-second count. Couple of substitutions for UNC Wilmington. Rob Wagner, number 12, and Kevin Miles, 35, check into the game. We've got a timeout at 11:28 remaining in the first half of this championship game. UNC Wilmington leads by 3.
All right, the week's over. Yeah, and the weekend's just beginning.
Here's how the good times get better. Stroh's and Stroh Light 15 and 30 packs. A convenient package at a special value. Get them wherever you buy your beer. Stroh's is smoking
here. Brooks Robinson here for All-Stars. 5 convenient locations. All-Stars, a true automotive discounter where every car is discounted every day. Choose from over 1,500 vehicles, some up to $1,000 below dealer's original cost. See All-Star Dodge in Baltimore, All-Star Central Dodge in Hagerstown, or All-Star Chrysler Plymouth Dodge in Prince Frederick. Or visit All-Star Chevrolet in Baltimore. Or on the Eastern Shore, All-Star Chevrolet Chrysler Plymouth Dodge, where just about everybody's credit is good with just $99 down.
Proctor with Kevin Gravy back in the Hampton Coliseum as we bring you the championship game of the CAA tournament tonight. From the Hampton Coliseum, Navy attempting to repeat as champion for the third consecutive year.
Navy really wants to win this game. They've won 12 in a row. They're really on a roll going into NCAA play. But UNCW is doing a good job containing David Robinson and getting Rousen the ball.
Robert McPherson has never had a losing season in 22 years of coaching. 11-8 UNC Wilmington. Rob Wagner in the game now, number 12, a senior from Muncie, Indiana. 33 is Bender. 25, Rawson, who has 5 points so far. Clock down to 20 seconds.
Seahawks are being very patient. They're trying to get the ball to Rouse in the scoring position. If they don't have that, they do have some good perimeter shooters, particularly three-point area.
Three-pointer by Wagner is good.
One of the guys right there. Wagner and Bender, Sandy Anderson, those three will throw up the three-pointer.
14-8, UNC Wilmington. Navy's best three-point shooters are Cliff Reese and Doug Wojcik. As it rim out, but he got a good shot and hustles after it. Manhurts. Wojcik for three. Rebound Russell. And he's called for traveling. No argument from Brian.
No. He went down and shuffled his feet. He knew it.
Davies hit just 4 of 16 shots. They shot better than 50% in each of the first two games of the tournament. Rousham again with a rebound, and Mann has nearly steals it.
They're struggling from the field, but they are also getting the offensive rebounds and giving themselves second and third chances. UNCW has got to do a better job checking off.
9:59 remaining in the first half. UNC Wilmington leads 14-8. The low-scoring first half. We saw Navy throw the first 4:45 of the game without scoring. Robinson forces a turnover. Look at him go around Rousham. Oh, but Rousham recovered nicely. He fouled him, but he stopped a sure dunk.
David Robinson's already got 2 steals. You have to be so careful right there. He plays the passing lane. Big guys playing a lane like that, you don't see that happen too often. David Robinson says it's showtime. Rousham does get the foul. It's a good foul on Rousham. It would have been a sure dunk.
Robinson had 60 steals on the season coming into this game. That's 12 more than the nearest man on the team, Doug Orgeron. I don't think I can ever remember a center leading his team in steals.
That just says something for his athletic ability and his great hands and speed and quickness.
14-9, UNC Wilmington. Seahawks have Wagner, Bender, Gary, Miles, and Rousham on the floor. This is Kevin Miles. Bender. He's got his first basket. It's 16-9 in favor of UNC Wilmington. Reese open in the corner. And Cliff Reese knocks it down.
That's his favorite spot. He likes that corner jumper. He'll nail three-pointers from there all day unless they guard him. You have to come out on Reese and Wojcik and then pack it in on Robert.
He moved into the starting lineup and replaced Tyler Whitaker, who was a fine outside shooter last year for Navy. Love that baseline corner jump shot. Good pressure by Wojcik. 8:45 remaining in the half. Navy's very aggressive in that zone.
UNCW has got to be careful with their passing. They're trying to use
well,
up
got Gary trapped, and Lieberts called for a foul.
Well, they're trying to trap Navy, that is. They're trying to trap anytime the ball gets on the sideline. They do a good job with the trap. I didn't really see the foul on Liebert there.
Looks like he put a leg into it. And a half remaining in the first half. A 5-point lead for UNC Wilmington. Been very patient, working to get good shots. Navy, on the other hand, is a little wild. They've taken quite a few bad shots.
They haven't really been in form. They've been playing so well. This is the worst I've seen them play. The worst start.
Rousham off glass. Rebound to David Robinson. Here comes Wojcik leading the break. Liebert is called for charging. We'd like to welcome those of you watching on ESPN tonight. Mel Proctor along with Kevin Gravy at the Hampton Coliseum in Hampton, Virginia, the championship of the Colonial Athletic Association. Navy is attempting to win the title for the third consecutive year, facing UNC Wilmington, a team that has never beaten Navy. The Middies are 7-0 against UNC Wilmington, including 2 wins in regular season this year. One of those, a 67-66 victory at UNC Wilmington, as David Robinson made a buzzer beater to win it. We have 7:39 remaining in the first half. UNC Wilmington leads 16-11.
UNCW is just doing the best they can to get that ball into David Robinson.
Robinson, Brian Rousham, the best players in the history of their schools. Each has scored 5 points so far. And Kevin Miles connects for the Seahawks.
Shooting well from the perimeter, that'll open it up for Rousham.
7-point lead for UNC Wilmington. Penalties, Doug Wojcik, 44, Kirk Reese. Leader 40, having a great tournament into Robinson. And we've got a foul. Bender is charged with a foul.
Every time David Robinson gets the ball inside, they just collapse. He has 2 and 3 bodies on him all the time. There's no way he can put the ball down on the floor. He's going to have to just look and take his shot.
6:57 remaining in the first half as Matt Hertz pans the long drive jump shot. He's come off the bench to score 4 points, and it's 18-13 UNC Wilmington. Kevin Miles in the 15th quarter. And it's out of bounds off Brian Lawson of UNC Wilmington. Sandy Anderson, who picked up two quick fouls, comes back in the game for UNC Wilmington. And we've got a timeout with 6:41 remaining in the first half. The Seahawks of UNC Wilmington lead Navy by five.
Sometimes every day seems like every other day. The way you used to have fun doesn't do it anymore.
Team sports tomorrow night as the Atlantic 10 postseason conference tournament continues. The nonstop excitement of the semifinal round getting underway at 9 o'clock. Del Proctor with Kevin Grevey back at the Hampton Coliseum. Two first-year coaches enjoying great success. Pete Herman and Robert McPherson. Of course, the criticism we always hear when a new coach takes over and is successful is that, well, he didn't recruit the players.
Yeah, but Pete Herman has done a good job because there was graduation of Butler and Whitaker, and he's just done a fine job putting his team together, and they've got a good record to show for it.
Reese in the man hurts. He's wide open underneath. Look at Lever fight for the rebound, but Kevin Miles takes it for UNC Wilmington. Wagner pushing the ball up. Bender over Manhurts, followed him a bit. Rousen trying to get it up on the follow shot. Really working hard. But Manhurts clears it out to Lever. Reese. And he got fouled by Rob Wagner.
Well, both teams are playing particularly hard. You saw this shot here for Reese. He's a real good medium-range jump shooter and uses the glass here on that. He did get fouled on the arm.
Reese at the free throw line, an 80% shooter. Brooke is a junior from Ellicott City, Maryland. There's a lot of folks in that area watching the game tonight. Reese has 4 points. Robinson leads Navy with five. Rousen has five for UNC Wilmington. There's not been much scoring in this first half. 3-point lead for the Seahawks.
UNCW is being very patient with the ball. They haven't taken too many bad shots. They're going to have to take good shots and limit their turnovers if they want to win this game.
After starting the game with a man-to-man defensive, Eddie's have never gone back to it. They stayed in his zone. Rousen around Robinson. Tough shot. And we've got a foul against Navy's Carl Liebert. That is his third foul. And Pete Herman will take him out.
Well, here's a nice attempt by Rousen. And Liebert
did not see a foul.
He just went straight up and pulled the rebound down. There was a lot of traffic in there, and I could see how the referee might have been shielded or something, but it's unfortunate because Liebert has been playing so well. And to lose him here in the first half will hurt Navy.
Greg Craver has replaced him. Craver had 8 rebounds in yesterday's game. He had 8 rebounds. Lieber led the scoring with 21 points and marked the first time that a midi other than Robinson had led the team in scoring or rebounding in the last 20 games.
Something else.
Miles tightroping the end line. Anderson gets it. Rousham off glass. Nice touch.
Sandy Anderson made that play. He's the one that made that happen. He put the ball right to the middle and dished it so nicely to Rousham.
Rousham has hit only 3 of 10 shots. He hadn't been shooting well in this tournament. He was 6 for 19 against Richmond. Anderson knocks it away. 2 minutes back on defense. Anderson tries it anyway. And a foul called on Greg Bender of UNC Wilmington. That's his second foul. Robert McPherson, a native of Texas, came to UNC Wilmington from Sam Houston State. Longtime high school coach in the state of Texas. 4:55 left in a half. UNC Wilmington leads by 5. Prather with the entry pass to Robinson.
Nice pass by Prather. Pass it right through the defense. A nice bounce back.
David missed his first 4 shots of the game, but he's heating up. He's 3 for 7 from the floor. Miles open up deep, but look at Robinson come from nowhere to smother it. What reaction?
He's so quick to the ball. It's unbelievable. It looked like Miles had a sure dunk.
Manley scores for Navy. He's playing well. He's got 6 points, and UNC Wilmington's lead is cut to 1. 20-19.
David Robinson really sparks his team with his blocked shots. Almost every shot that he blocks results into a fast break basket.
4 minutes left in the half. And we've got a whistle, a foul off the ball on Kevin Miles. He and Reese knocking heads. Charles Cherry returns for UNC Wilmington. Let's see who's going to come out. It'll be Miles who will leave.
Well, Reese and Miles are starting to bang and throwing elbows at one another.
Well, Robert McPherson is airing out Miles. He's really upset at him.
Well, I think he's mad at the fact that he threw a flagrant elbow into Reese. He don't need that.
Navy on a 9-2 run. They've tied the score at 20, and Reese can give the Minis the lead. They have never been ahead in the game, and they take the lead. 21-20, Navy. 3:57 left in the half. They can be explosive, as James Patterson found out yesterday. They saw Navy hit him with 14 straight points in the second half and pretty well put the game away.
They did that without David Robinson in the game. That's just ironic.
Anderson from long range. He has 4 points. And UNC Wilmington's back on top.
Yesterday he had 4 three-pointers in the game, so he is a threat from out there.
Robinson surrounded, feeds Prather. Rebound, Brian Rousham doing an excellent job on the boards. He has 7 rebounds. They approach the 3-minute mark. 22-21 lead for UNC Wilmington.
Seahawks are doing a good job working against this 2-3 zone. A lot of perimeter passing. They're getting cutters to the basket. And it's really spreading out the Navy zone.
Shot clock down to 8 seconds, and they'll turn it over. So an over and back violation. The ball goes to Navy.
McPherson's a real motivator. He stays on his kids. And they make a bad play, he lets them know it. They make a good one, he lets them know it.
2-3 zone being used by the Seahawks. Reese with a three-pointer. And he's got a foul. John Craig Prather, maybe, for pushing.
Craig Prather's a very aggressive player who is really getting more confidence from his coach. Here he is. He's very aggressive, goes after everything. He just gets a body on one of the guards for UNCW.
2:20 remaining in the first half. UNC Wilmington leading 22-21. Rowson. Rowson turns on Manhertz. Rebound to Kerry Manhertz. He clears it out to Doug Wojcik. Robinson dumps it inside to Manhertz. And another foul on Craig Prather.
Prather attracts a lot of attention in there because of his hustle and aggressiveness, but I don't think Pete Herman minds that kind of foul. As long as you're playing hard, there's nothing wrong with that. And here he gets good position, jumps into the Seahawks.
Kevin Miles is back in the game for North Carolina Wilmington, replacing Charles Cherry. A minute 50 left in the half. UNC Wilmington with a one-point lead. Anderson looking to get off a shot, having a tough time against his Navy zone. The shot clock winding down again to 13 seconds. We're going to have to take a shot. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Rowson puts one up.
That's what they're trying to do, is get that ball to Rowson. That's why they're being so patient and using that 45-second shot clock.
Brian Rowson has 9 points. David Robinson has 7. He's fouled. Wagner hit him on the arm. Second foul on Rob Wagner. Mark Geary returns for UNC Wilmington, replacing Sandy Anderson. David Robinson is 1-for-2 at the free throw line tonight. According to Pete Herman, over the years, David Robinson has not played particularly well against North Carolina Wilmington. He has 8 points in this game.
And Rowson has had good games against him on the other hand, so that's why this is a pretty good matchup and should be a very close game.
24-22, North Carolina Wilmington leading with 45 seconds left. Strong baseline drive by Miles, but he comes up short. Here comes Wojcik. Gary flops back, trying to draw a charge. See what they'll call. They're going to call a foul on Miles.
There was a nice move. He just couldn't get it up off on glass. Wojcik was baited there. David Robinson, it looks like, fouled him. Now Miles got in there for a reach-in.
Ricky Griffin, number 14, a sophomore from St. Louis, Missouri, is in the game now for the Seahawks. He's a transfer from Allen Community College in Iola, Kansas. Doug Wojcik, scoreless in the first half. He's put all 4 shots on the floor. Doug is telling us that his younger brother is a fine high school player in West Virginia. He's a senior and will be attending Loyola College in Baltimore next year. Another rebound for Brian Rowson. 24-23, UNC Wilmington with 24 seconds left. First half action in the CAA championship game in the Hampton Coliseum.
Seahawks will just look for one shot now. Work the clock down with about 10 seconds, try to go into their offensive play.
8 seconds left. 5 seconds. 2 seconds as Gary puts it up. And that's the end of the first half. Very close first half. Robert McPherson's team leads with a one-point lead. At the end of the first half, it's UNC Wilmington 24, Navy 23. You're watching CAA basketball on the Home Team Sports Television Network. We'll be right back.
and Stroh Light. It's a family tradition passed down from one generation to another for over 200 years. It's what guarantees that smooth, consistent taste for generations to come.
A good time's better with a good time beer. It's Stroh's, it's Stroh in here. Stroh's, it's Stroh in here.
I'm feeling good from my head to my shoes. Know where I'm going and I know what to do. I've tidied up my point of view. I got a new attitude.
Wilmington is attempting to upset Navy for the CAA championship, and the Seahawks lead by one at halftime of this championship game. Hello again, Mel Proctor, along with Kevin Grevy. And I know Pete Herman of Navy has to be very concerned with his team shooting. On the season, the Middies shoot 52%. They've shot better than 50% in each of the first two tournament games, but in the first half, they shot 32%.
Well, that's right, Mel. Pete Herman's got to be upset because his team, when it's really on the line, the championship game, he would expect them to come out and shoot a lot better and get better shots, but they've been forcing some shots. David Robinson was guilty of that early in the first half where he got off to a bad start because some of the shots that he took just really were not good ones. And I think Navy has got to regroup here at halftime and take more time on the shot clock and try to get the ball to David Robinson in a good shooting position. Now, on the other hand, UNCW has been very patient with the zone. They're moving the ball around the perimeter with their first option to get the ball to Rousem, either to try to get David Robinson in foul trouble, but he is also their best shooter. And then if they don't get that, then they go to their perimeter shot. So their game plan has been good, a good one. Navy, on the other hand, hasn't been playing well at all.
Navy surprisingly came out in a man-to-man defense to open the game, and that's when UNC Wilmington jumped out to that early lead. Did that surprise you that they played man-to-man?
Well, they will play the man-to-man on occasion, but throughout the tournament, they've been playing a 2-3 zone, and in two previous games that they played UNCW, they played zone. So I think they were just trying to do something different to maybe throw them off, but what it ended up doing was get Rousem involved, and he drew a foul on David Robinson.
Well, what do we look for in the second half? Any changes on the part of these two coaches?
Well, certainly, I think Navy is going to be a little bit more patient with their shots and try to get some penetration by Wojcik so that Liebert, who's had such a great tournament, he can get some of his shots. Liebert had 3,000 in the first half, so he was kind of quiet.
Well, we build this as a matchup between Brian Rousem and David Robinson. Rousem and Robinson, both all-conference selections. David Robinson, the player of the year of the conference the last 3 years. In the first half, Rousem had 9 points and David Robinson had 8. But David, of course, is closing out a great career at Navy. He'll move on to the NBA. We all look forward to that. And earlier, he talked about his career, his 4 years at the Naval Academy.
My growth. I mean, freshman year, it was real tough on me just because I did get in there every day. And just in practice, I was beat up every day, and it was tough. And now, the biggest difference is just I've put on a lot of weight and I've lifted a lot of weights, and so I'm a lot bigger and stronger, and I have more endurance. So it's been gradually getting better and better, and I take it as a challenge now. I try not to get angry when I get elbowed or double or triple teamed. I take it as a challenge, and I think that makes me that much better of a player, because every night I go out and, you know, I know I have to perform against whatever defense I'm going to face. You know, our team, everywhere we go, we're known as Robinson and Company. And, you know, it's tough on the guys because the guys have been everything to me. I mean, I can't dribble the ball up and down the court. There's no way, you know, I could get it every time without great passes from Doug and Cliff and Carl. And it's just kind of foolish to say that. I mean, seeing as we have a pretty good record, we played some pretty good teams, and we do all right. Yeah. And same thing with the conference. We have a lot of tough teams that go out and they beat some real good teams, New Orleans and Northeastern. And it's you know, one player doesn't make a conference as it doesn't make a team. Last year we were real successful. Lost a couple key players in Vernon Butler, inside forward, and Kyle Whitaker, our shooting guard. And we lost a player early who was slated to start at the three spot for us, Nate Bailey. So coming into the season, we had some tremendous doubts. And we had some young players who were going to have to come off the bench and contribute for us this to be a successful season. And Doug Orgic's come in and improved so much from last season just on his shooting alone. I mean, he's shooting three-pointers for us with a lot of confidence. And he's handling the ball as well as he's ever handled the ball. And what can I say about the way he gets it inside? He's fantastic. And, you know, I played with Kenny Smith and Tommy Emmerger. There's no way they could pass it inside nearly as well as Doug does, and I'd put him right up there with them. I have to be a dominant force. I have to be a force inside. I have to be what the other team concentrates on. I mean, that's when our other guys hurt the other team, is when the other team's looking at me and saying, we got to stop that big guy. You know, what I have to do is I have to stop them from bringing it into the lane with confidence. Defensively, I have to be really aggressive and be noticed out there. And offensively, score points. I mean, you know, that's why I don't place a lot of emphasis on my scoring average, because that's what I do for the team. I mean, I score. I mean, if you're going to get the ball 20 times a game, you're going to score a lot of points. So I don't place a lot of emphasis on that. What I like and what I really appreciate about my game is I go in there, I rebound. You know, I've tried to improve my offensive rebounding this year, and rebounding is really important to me, as are my block shots and my steals, because that shows, you know, my defensive level rising, and I'm becoming more of the type of player that I'd like to be. So I just have to be a major force out there to have the other team looking at and worrying about constantly. So that's how I see my role. And everyone else knows their role real well. You know, we don't ask everyone to do a lot of things. And you know, we tell Derek to go out there and rebound. We tell Doug to go out there and get the ball inside. Or when you're wide open, shoot that three-pointer. And Cliffy, you know, Cliffy has to generate some offense for us. And everyone knows that they have to play some tough defense. And I think this year, defensively, we've been a real tough team. So it's a good role-oriented situation, and I think we do a good job with it. There's been a few tough centers. I played against Sabonis from the Russian team. You know, he's 7'2", about 250. He's real athletic, real strong, and I was very impressed by him because he's a good athlete at that size, and that's unusual. I mean, he came in and talked to me a couple times. It's quite embarrassing, but just showed me his great athletic ability. And he's very tough. And I'd have to say the other center would be Tito Horford. He's young right now. I mean, he hasn't got a lot of experience, but he's strong. He's very strong. He's very confident, and he has a great hook shot. And he rebounds real strong. So he's going to be a great player in his time. You know, it's going to take him a year or two to get into the rhythm, but he's definitely going to be real tough.
Through the cold of winter, whenever your family needs it, the Lennox Pulse Gas Furnace sends gentle heartbeats of steady, quiet, even warmth throughout your home. No other furnace heats like it. No open flame, near total efficiency. The Pulse was developed by Lennox, the efficiency experts who care for your family's comfort and safety. With the Lennox Pulse, you know you have the best. At the heart of your family's comfort, no furnace heats like the Lennox Pulse. We'll be right back.
Meet the Smiths and the Joneses. A new car, Mr. Smith? Nice. Cost a lot, huh? Yeah, but in 5 years, she's all yours. And Mr. Jones, new car too, eh? Beautiful. Pricey, too. Oh, really? An Allstate lease. Good idea. No down payment? Paying less per month than buying? No service hassles? And a new one in 3 years? Seems like a world of difference between those new cars. That much difference. An Allstate lease gives you more car for less money. Call Allstate today.
They've flown south for the winter, but Home Team Sports keeps you on top of the 1987 edition of the Orioles as they ready themselves for another exciting season. See five exhibition ball games as we take you live to Southern Florida, where the Birds battle the Yankees, the Expos, and the Red Sox. That's Orioles Exhibition Baseball, live and exclusively on the channel you cheer for, Home Team Sports.
Back to the Hampton Coliseum, Mel Proctor along with Kevin Grevey bringing you the CAA championship game as UNC Wilmington leads Navy by one at the half in the battle between David Robinson and Brian Rousham. Rousham has outscored Robinson 9-8 and out-rebounded him, which may be even more important, 8-3. Let's take a look at some first half highlights involving the two stars.
Here we see Brian Rousham go over Robinson for two. He was able here early to get a three-pointer. Nice three-point play. He feels that he can take David Robinson and get him off his feet. Here's a nice pass by Brather. David Robinson only had seven attempts. That was one of the few baskets that he was able to get in the first half.
Robinson, though, was a factor on defense. Three steals and three blocks.
And here's one of them. What a spectacular block that is. Not too many players could be out of position and make that kind of play. And he hustles on down the floor. Manhurst has been playing pretty well in the tournament. Gets a basket here. Here we'll see a turnaround jump shot by Rousham, and you know, that's what they're trying to do, try to get the ball to him. He's very active inside. You see how mobile he is. He establishes real good position and hits the leaning jumper, which he's done so many times in his career.
Rousham hit 4 of 12 shots from the floor in the first half. Navy has to be very concerned with their shooting. 32%. UNC Wilmington, no great shakes at 39%. Rebound totals, though, in UNC Wilmington's favor, 22-14. Rousham has grabbed 8. David Robinson's going to have to get on the boards, and UNC Wilmington has the lead despite committing 8 turnovers. Rousham, the leading scorer with 9 points. No one else has more than 4 for the Seahawks. David Robinson has 8. Cliff Rees, Kerry Manhurst with 6 apiece.
Neither one of the big guys really have been too effective offensively. Rousham, however, has been able to be on the boards. He's a terrific rebounder, second leading rebounder in the conference, and one of the leaders in the country. David Robinson, on the other hand, he's got to get the ball. For some reason, Navy was content with getting Manhurst and Reese and these other shots, when I think David Robinson, either he's got to be more active to get position, or they got to concentrate and try to get the ball to him.
Not many three-pointers taken by either team, and normally both clubs like the three-pointer. Navy had attempted 225 coming into the game, and UNC Wilmington 292.
That's a lot of three-pointers by both clubs. They will use that three-pointer effectively.
Cheerleaders for that greeting. Spent some time with some of the Seahawks boosters last night, didn't we? A little hospitality suite they had open.
Yeah, there is a big contingency of these UNC people here. I think they have more people here at the tournament than any other school, and they love their Seahawks.
Remember yesterday, Navy led by, or was down by one at the half, and then James Madison hit a three-pointer, but then from that point on, Navy exploded for 14 straight points, so they're capable of doing it quickly.
Navy is an explosive team, and they can get that done with shot blocking of David Robinson. That's how he usually turns these games around. Such a gifted defensive player also.
Navy has led only once at 21-20. It'll be Navy's ball as we open the second half. They go with David Robinson, Derek Turner, Carl Liebert, Cliff Reeves, and Doug Wojcik, the same lineup that started the game. And UNC Wilmington will open with Brian Rousham, Sandy Anderson, Mark Gehry, Greg Bender, and Charles Cherry, the same way they started the game.
The Seahawks start out in a man-to-man here in the second half.
And a turnover by Navy.
David Robinson looks a little dejected here. Tries to perk his teammates up, but that's a bad start for him. They want to try to get off to a better start than that.
Navy back in his own. Bender, 33. Rousham is 25. 31, Cherry. Anderson, 22. And 15, Mark Gehry. They've got him trapped. But he gets out of it. Anderson with a 16-footer. He has just 6 points after firing in a career-high 24 yesterday. And in that game, he hit 4 of 7 three-pointers against Richmond. Three-point lead. Robinson tries to get some of it back. David with a long rebound and loses it again.
Well, what's wrong with David right now? He looks a little bit lethargic. He's trying his best to get involved, but it's just not happening for him. He's going to have to let the game come to him and not force it too much.
Wojcik pressures Anderson.
Ooh, that's over him. Yeah.
Yep, over and back.
Sandy Anderson crossed the half-court line, and then his right foot went back over.
UNC Wilmington lost a talented guard early in the season. In fact, he was injured in the first Navy game. Adam Porter, who was the Kentucky Junior College Player of the Year, he probably be a starter, but he's been out of action all year with a knee injury.
Yeah, Robert McPherson said his kicker lighted up.
Charging foul on David Robinson, no basket. He picked up his second foul. Boy, he's having a rough second half.
Well, the first three possessions have gone against Navy. Two turnovers and now another one right here with a charge.
26-23, UNC Wilmington.
We'll see the other angle of it. One of his patented moves just didn't work for him that time.
Well, Bender's open underneath. Anderson didn't see him right away because he was surrounded by Navy players.
Oh, he was in there 2 or 3 seconds yelling for the ball.
Carl Liebert has just picked up his fourth foul. Navy has problems.
Well, nothing is going right for Navy. Liebert is in foul trouble. Here you see the play. It's a nice pass, just a little bit late to him. Liebert didn't want to commit that foul, but he did want to put some pressure on Bender.
See if Pete Herman will take him out or if he'll stay with him. Looks like he's going to get man in for him as Greg Bender misses the first free throw. Byron Hopkins, a freshman from Chicago, checks in, replacing Liebert.
That'll give him a little more height on the boards with Hopkins in there. He's just a freshman, not real experienced, but he does do a good job around the basket.
UNC Wilmington has attempted only 3 free throws in this game.
Well, they've had a nice game plan, and if they've been very patient with themselves, try to limit their turnovers, get the ball in the Rousing.
27-23, UNC Wilmington, and Robinson is roughed up by Brian Rousing. That's his second foul.
David's working very hard to try to get position here. Rousing trying to front, try to keep the ball from David. It's called for the foul. Rousing's really got his work cut out for him. It's David Robinson, one of the best players in the country, is so hard to guard.
And a quick foul underneath against UNC Wilmington.
Here, just a quick play by Turner. He took the ball with the basket. usually when he gets it, that's what he wants to do, is power to the basket. However, he does get called for a lot of offensive charges.
Greg Bender whistled for his third foul. Turner only a 53% free throw shooter. That's his first point of the game. Derek started 9 games last year for Navy. Played at the Naval Prep School before coming to the Academy. 27-25, North Carolina Wilmington, 2 minutes into the second half. Anderson and Wojcik in a foot race. Navy's trying to trap.
Wojcik's really putting a lot of pressure on the point guard. He's just trying to pick the tempo of the game up a little bit.
And Cliff Reese commits a foul.
That over-aggressiveness did cause a foul here. Cliff Reese and Wojcik, the two guards, are doing their best to put the pressure on the backcourt of the Seahawks. They're not as quick as the Seahawk guards, but they do a good job of pressure.
Navy has 3 team fouls. That's the first on Reese. Seahawks again spreading it out, moving the ball quickly against the zone. Nelson floating through the lane, trying to get free for a jump shot. Anderson, three-pointer. Rebound to Byron Hopkins at Navy. So Navy wants to pick up the tempo.
Yeah, they do. They're trying it with their defense, and every opportunity they're trying to run with it.
Wojcik looks into Robinson. David powers his way to the basket. It counts, and he'll go to the line.
Wojcik made a great play there to get that bounce pass into David Robinson. In traffic, he made a terrific pass. I don't know how many times he has given those assists to David Robinson. Great play here. Really made it happen. Of course, Robinson, he does so well in getting position. He hangs in the air, switches hands for 7-1 man to do that.
David has 11 points, and he just moved past Joe Dumars, formerly of McNeese State, now with the Detroit Pistons, in the 12th spot in the all-time NCAA scoring list with 2,607 points. And they pass a couple more today as well. Navy leads by 1, 28-27. They've led only twice in this game. Anderson, he had the shot, but throws it back out to Gary for 3. Here comes Navy on the run. Wojcik will take it himself. That'll be a charging foul, but the basket counts.
Wojcik is really trying to pick the tempo up here. His hustle is something else. Here, he takes on 2 Seahawks. He goes on in. That's a good foul. You don't mind that because he took it hard to the basket. It's a good trade-off. Foul for the basket.
And Navy leads by 3, 30-27. Navy got off to a bad start in the second half. 2 turnovers and an offensive foul on Robinson. They seem to be getting on track now. Anderson, Gary, great pass in the defender, but Robinson, a tremendous block. Incredible.
2 terrific plays there. Robinson, he just continues to block shots when he's out of position like this.
And Sammy Anderson commits a foul underneath. That's his third foul.
Look at him go up and get that ball. Unbelievable. He's so quick to the basketball.
Of course, he's been compared to all the great men who preceded him in college basketball. Bill Walton, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Wilt Chamberlain. Of course, more recently, Patrick Ewing. And you and I were talking about the comparison between the two last night. I think we both agreed that he can do more things than Ewing could coming out of college.
I think he's a better offensive player, a better shooter than Pat was in college. Pat's developed a terrific offensive game.
Derek Turner scores on the follow shot. Navy opens up their biggest lead, 32-27. They have scored 9 straight points, and UNC Wilmington will call a timeout. So the Middies are beginning to open things up with 15:41 remaining in the second half. Navy leads 32-27, and you're watching CAA basketball on the Home Team Sports Television Network.
Sports. The channel you cheer for.
It's a battle of NBA Atlantic Division foes as the Bullets meet the New Jersey Nets Wednesday night on Home Team Sports. The action gets underway at 7:30 following the Bullets report at 7. The Bullets tonight are playing in Atlanta. They have moved into second place in the Atlantic Division, percentage points ahead of the 76ers. And they've been playing great basketball, so you want to pencil that one in on your sports schedule. Navy, after an awful first half in which they shot only 32%, is showing a lot of improvement in this second half.
They're really picking up their hustle. Look at Wojcik out front, trying to trap at every opportunity. Their defense is making it happen.
Ricky Griffin connects to UNC Wilmington. His first pass of the game, he just checked in. He's replaced Mark Berry in the backcourt. 32-29, Navy. Robinson, blocked by Bender, but almost muscles it in. Showed his strength on that shot.
Sure did. He took the defensive man up with him.
When you talk about strength among centers, Wilt Chamberlain, the strongest ever, and it's kind of appropriate to mention him because this is the 25th anniversary of the game in which he scored 100 points against the New York Knicks in Hershey, Pennsylvania. 25 years ago today.
Poor Darrell Imhoff. Wasn't it Darrell Imhoff that was guarding?
Imhoff said the next time if the Knicks faced the 76ers, Imhoff got a standing ovation when he came out of the game after fouling out because Wilt had only scored 54. Robinson moves out on Anderson. Rousen trying to get him off his
nice
feet.
Pass.
Finds Bender. He misses. Cherry on the offensive glass. Rousen finally puts it down.
Well, Rousen showed there why he's one of the top rebounders in the country. He really does go to the board well.
32-31, Navy. Both teams, both stars have scored 11 points. Robinson, Wojcik connects on a three-pointer. 35-31, Navy.
Navy guards are really hustling, trying to create a steal or something for themselves.
Cherry misses. And it's out of bounds. Whoa, UNC Wilmington thought it should have been their ball. Griffin let it roll out of bounds. He could have grabbed it. He apparently thought it had been touched by a Navy player, and that's what he's telling the officials. Stand corrected. That last three-pointer by Navy was by Cliff Reese rather than Wojcik. Now Wojcik will pull one up. Look at Cherry get up. Only 6'6", but he can really leap.
He's the best leaper in the conference.
He's got nine rebounds.
Really gets up in the air.
Actually, the Bullets are playing in Atlanta tonight. The Hawks lead 52-50 in the second quarter. Brian Rousen has hit just 5 of 15 shots in this game. Bender. And Cherry trying to climb Robinson's back, commits the foul. That's his second.
Cherry goes to the boards hard, a little bit out of control. But it's sometimes what it takes to get that offensive rebounding. Just got to go hard to the basket. David Robinson is always around the basket.
5 team fouls on UNC Wilmington. Navy has 4. The Middies lead 35-31. Robinson over Rousen. Oh, my. Put it down, David.
He's something else. Fouls his own shot for the dunk there. It's one gifted athlete.
He's got 13 points. The Middies have their biggest lead, 6 points. So we've got a foul.
David Robinson flashed in the middle, received the pass from Wojcik, missed it, but boy, he just stays with it all the time. Makes it look easy.
Last foul was on Cliff Reese of Navy. 12:45 remaining in the second half. Championship game of the CAA tournament. Navy leads 37-31.
The Seahawks need to hit some of these three-pointers that they're known for.
Here comes Wojcik off the turnover. Reese. Give Wojcik some credit for turning up the volume on this offense in the second half. What a shot by David Robinson. It counts and a foul.
Well, they're feeling it now. They're really clicking. Right here is a great move. He runs the baseline and then turns and shoots. He was on the other side of the basket and jumped forward for that shot. I know how tough a shot that is. Jumps out and in.
Bowers
he's
on.
He's pumped up.
Ricky Griffin. Mark Gary is back in the game now for UNC Wilmington, replacing Greg Bender. Robinson has 15.7 rebounds, four block shots.
Well, David Ross has put it in the fifth gear here these last few minutes.
16 for David, and Navy leads by 9, 40-31. We've talked about how explosive they can be. They can also be subject to horrendous stretches like the one they had in the second half against William & Mary. Saw a 22-point lead dwindle to 7, and they played a very poor first half tonight.
Yeah, they do have their hot and cold streaks, and sometimes those streaks can run 4 or 5 minutes.
But they've got it going right now as Hopkins makes the steal. Navy trying to go up by 11. Wojcik all the way, a little out of control. Griffin throws it out of bounds, and Navy will get the ball back.
It's been plays like Wojcik just made there is what's really picked up Navy and has gotten them into more of a transition game.
UNC Wilmington calls timeout with 11:50 remaining. David Robinson has 16 points. He's the leading scorer in the game. Brian Rousham has 11, and the only two in double figures. Navy playing well despite the absence of Carl Liebert, who picked up his fourth foul and is on the bench. He's been one of the most consistent players in this tournament.
Carl Liebert would have had any kind of game at all today. He might have made the all-tournament team. Still might. But he's really had quite a tournament. He's given Navy that extra dimension to their game, which they've been lacking most of the year.
North Carolina Wilmington left 27-23, 1 minute into the second half. And it didn't look like things were any better for Navy as they were turning the ball over. Robinson picked up a charging foul. But from that point on, Navy has outscored the Seahawks 17-4.
And that's the kind of stretches that we talk about. Navy can't make that stretch without David Robinson blocking shots and running the court. That's what he does best.
11 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in the game. Navy leads by 9, 40-31. Navy goes with Robinson, Hopkins, Turner on the front line. A big front line, about the biggest they can put on the floor. And Reese and Wojcik in the backcourt.
And that graphic there showed the shooting, and the shooting for Navy in the second half has been a lot better than what it was the first.
Well, Blocker with Kevin Greeley back at the Hampton Coliseum as Sandy Anderson makes a steal for North Carolina Wilmington. Navy leads it 40-31 with 11:28 left in the game. David Robinson picking up in the second half. He has 16 points. Brian Rossum with UNC Wilmington, the leading scorer for the Seahawks with 11.
Seahawks are having a tough time getting a good shot with this Navy zone.
Griffin goes baseline and scores in the tip-in. Right? Effort on the offensive glass by Ricky Griffin, who has 4 points, and it's 40-33, Navy.
Seahawks with good offensive rebounding. Rousey's terrific on the board, so is Cherry.
Derek Turner, Reese, Wojcik, Byron Hopkins, the freshman, getting some playing time, and Carl Liebert in foul trouble. Reese is wide open. Rebound to Brian Rousham. Rousham, who is not a heavily recruited player out of Columbia, North Carolina. He was recruited only by UNC Wilmington and Pembroke State. It was Mel Gibson, the former coach here, that brought him in. A lot of people who didn't think he could play major college basketball.
Boy, he's matured into a fine basketball player.
Three-pointer by Sandy Anderson is short. Look at Griffin go after him.
They continue to get these offensive boards. It's giving them second and third opportunities. Navy's got to do a better job of checking off if they want to maintain this lead.
It doesn't appear to me that Rousham is looking for his shots as much as he did in the first half, or working as hard for position.
Here comes Wojcik. Get David Robinson on you. That'll change your mind.
Nice acting job by Mark Gary, who flopped backwards, and the official spotted the charge on Derek Turner.
Derek Turner does have a problem with this. He puts his head down and just goes to the basket. He's got to keep his head up and not be so predictable.
As I recall, when you played in the NBA with the Bullets and the Bucks, you were pretty good at flopping backwards. Did you practice in front of your mirror in the hotel room?
It was about the only defense I played, Mel.
That and the Matador defense.
Yeah.
Wave at them as they go by. 9.5 remaining in the second half. Championship game of the CAA tournament as Mark Gary connects on a three-pointer.
Gary's been a little quiet in this game. He is a good three-point shooter. They attempt almost 300, 400 three-pointers this season, so they're going to need some of that to get himself back in the game.
Navy's lead is cut to four. Reese drops it into Byron Hopkins. And a long rebound to Cliff Reese. 9 minutes left. Doug Wojcik puts up the three-pointer. Hopkins with a rebound. Rawson got a piece of it. And we've got a held ball. The arrow points to North Carolina Wilmington. Substitution for the Seahawks. Greg Bender, 33, is back in. Robert McPherson and Pete Herman signaling for a timeout. We've got a break in the action at 8:58 remaining in the championship game of the CAA tournament. Navy leads 40-36.
The week's over.
Yeah, and the weekend.
20 Washington Boulevard.
Mel Proctor with Kevin Gravy back in the Hampton Coliseum. Navy opened up a 9-point lead, but North Carolina Wilmington has rallied, scoring 5 straight points to cut the Middies lead to 4 points. A lot of professional scouts down here this weekend to watch David Robinson and Brian Rawson in particular. We saw George Irvin, the player personnel director of the Indiana Pacers, and Jeff Rulin, the 76ers injured center, was down here scouting for his team, and the Milwaukee Bucks scout was here. Of course, Robinson is the main guy they're watching, but they're also taking a look at Rawson and several other players in the tournament. And I was kidding George Irvin. I said, well, why would you even draft Robinson? There's no Navy base in Indiana. And he said, we'll build one.
Yeah, I'm sure they would to have their hands on David Robinson.
Robinson has 16 points tonight. Kind of taken over in the second half. Three-pointer by Mark Gary. And it's out of bounds off whom? It'll be Navy's ball. Bobby Jones, number 23, is in the game now for Navy. 8.5 left in the game as the Middies try to win their third straight tournament championship. They were the regular season champ, losing only one game. That was to Richmond. Hopkins scores inside.
Yeah, that's one of the future players for Navy. He shows that he does have some offensive moves in there.
6-point lead for the Middies. I said earlier, it appears to me that Rawson is not working as hard to get open as he did in the first half. He was moving down the lane and coming off the baseline and moving out the free throw area, trying to get open, but he's not moving as much. I don't know if he's getting tired or what.
No, there early in the game he was up to the challenge and he was taking the action to David Robinson. He's been a little more passive in the second half.
Worked hard that time and it pays off.
He's got that nice little ball fake that keeps David Robinson off balance, and so he's able to shoot the ball over him. Not too many players can do that in this league.
Rawson has hit 6 of 16 shots, and he cuts Navy's lead to 4 with 7.5 left. Reese to Robinson in the crowd over Rawson. 18 points for the All-American center, David Robinson, and Navy leads by 6. He's hit his last 3 shots.
Just moving the ball on the perimeter. I think they need to attack that zone a little more. If they're going to be satisfied with just moving the ball out there, they're going to have to hit some 3-pointers. Otherwise, they got to find some cutters to the basket.
Rawson trying to position himself down low to take a pass, but David Robinson's doing a good job against him in the zone. Shot clock is down to 7 seconds. Robinson wouldn't buy the fake and swats it away. That's his 5th rejection of the game.
He's got uncanny timing and ability to block these shots. You know, you've heard Bill Russell say you don't leave your feet until the shot's taken. There's an example of his shot blocking skills.
6 and a half remaining in the game. Rawson around Robinson with a half hook. Pretty shot.
Nice move. Rawson's got a few nice moves underneath there. It's the first time we've seen him use the hook.
Ryan Rawson has 15 points. David Robinson scored 18. And Navy leads 44-40.
Seahawks have been able to stay close to Navy, even with that great spurt of theirs.
Wojcik for three. Seahawks are sagging back on that zone into the middle, trying to shut down Robinson. They're giving up the outside shot.
And most teams do play that. They just dare Wojcik and Reese and Liepert and those players to go ahead and say, beat us, shoot the ball on outside. They don't want David Robinson to get off and get 40 or 50 points.
Griffin with a three-pointer, and that cuts Navy's lead to 1 point. Ricky Griffin nails a three-pointer. He's played well off the bench tonight with 7 points.
Well, we were saying that they have a lot of three-pointer threats out there. Three, four players for the Seahawks involved. And good range.
And Robinson nearly tied up inside. In fact, the held ball is called. The Seahawks are giving Wojcik and Reese the outside shot. They're saying, go ahead and take it. We don't want the ball going to Robinson. If it does, he's going to be surrounded. Points to Navy, so the middies will have the ball. There's a comparison between the two great setters, Robinson and Rawson.
Both are playing fairly well in the second half.
Robinson feeds Hopkins. And the freshman has his second basket as Navy leads 46-43. 5 minutes left in regulation. Bender to Gary for the wide open jumper. He's really struggling. Rawson over the top for the rebound. Look at Rawson go after it, just out hustling the Navy players. Robinson blocks another one. The foul is going to be called on Brian Rawson.
Now, that's not much reward for that great effort that Rawson had there on the offensive boards. Just a terrific effort by him. There he is, just banging and battling on the boards.
They jump back into Byron Hopkins.
And he may have.
Navy takes a timeout with 4:39 left. The middies open up a 9-point lead, and it appeared they had things under control. But UNC Wilmington has come back, getting a lift from Ricky Griffin off the bench. He fired in a 3-pointer to cut the lead to 1. Right now, Navy leads by 3.
The Seahawks here want an upset. They know the only chance to get the NCAA tournament is to win, get the automatic bid. So a lot is on the stake for these guys, and it's a great opportunity. Here, just down 3. Top-ranked Navy. They're playing a terrific game, and Robert McPherson's game plan has just been right on time.
UNC Wilmington has been involved in a lot of close games this year. 12 of their 29 games have been decided by 4 points or less, and 5 have been decided by 1 point. Timeout situation. Each team has 3 remaining. This is the farthest the Seahawks have ever advanced in the CAA tournament. Since joining the league 3 years ago. They lost the first round game to George Mason in 1985, and last year they were beaten by Navy in the semifinals, although it was a close game. The Middies won 62-60.
And like we said, they've never beaten Navy since they've been playing basketball and teaming up, and they've had some close games, but they've always come up short. There's Liepert. I know he wishes he was out there. There's 4 fouls. Just removed himself from any of the action. He probably won't be in until 1 or 2 minutes left.
UNC Wilmington has out-rebounded Navy in this game, 32-24. Rawson has grabbed 12, and Charles Cherry has 9. Neil Fenton, number 4, is in the game for the first time. So they've got 3 guards in there now. Fenton, Wojcik, and Reese, all excellent outside shooters. Robinson pounds it inside. 20 points for David, and Navy leads by 5.
They go to the money man, David Robinson, and Pete Herman doing exactly what he has to do, and it's get the ball to David.
Sandy Anderson connects on the baseline jumper. 48-45, Navy, 4 minutes left. Now it looks like UNC Wilmington's the man-to-man. Fenton comes off the bench, cold, nails it.
Tough to do, too. Sitting the whole game and comes off and hits his first shot.
50-45. Navy, 3:45 left. The Seahawks will call a timeout. So they have 2 left. a moment, we'd like to thank all the sports information directors at the various schools, the CAA, for their cooperation and help, not only in this tournament, but throughout the season. We've enjoyed our coverage again this year. Glad to have you aboard, Kevin. You've done an outstanding job in your first year.
Oh, I've really enjoyed it. I've had a lot of fun in visiting the campuses of all the CAA schools and getting to know some of the players and coaches. SI and athletic directors. It's a real classy conference, and I hope I can do it again next year.
There was a media basketball game this afternoon, and a lot of people are very disappointed that you didn't show up.
I had too much to eat last night, Mel, and also I had to do a little paperwork for my restaurant.
Yeah, right.
The holiday is over with, and I go back home tomorrow.
We'll give your restaurant a plug. Reeves in
Falls Church, Virginia, Route 50 Gallows Road. We just opened last week, so my wife and I got a lot of work to do.
So come on down. Kevin Grevy out in the real world after frolicking in the NBA for several years.
Yeah, now it's time to go back to work. You know?
We have 3 minutes and 43 seconds left. AB leads 50 to 45. Navy's bench again doing an excellent job. The starters for the midshipmen are shooting only 37%, but the bench, the reserves have come in, are shooting 50% from the floor. Griffin is fouled by Cliff Reese. That's his third foul.
Well, you mentioned the reserves playing well for Navy. In both the previous games here in the tournament, they've been able to play their reserves and get them some minutes, and that really has helped them here in his close game.
That's the seventh foul on Navy. Both teams are over the limit now. Ricky Griffin will go to the free throw line. Griffin, a 55% shooter, so he's not a good free throw shooter, but sinks the first.
He's really playing well for the Seahawks. He's come off the bench, hit that big three-pointer, he's gotten on the boards, and he's got 8 points and three rebounds in the short time he's been in there.
Griffin averaging just 3.5 points a game on the season. Bender tips it out to Griffin. The Seahawks get it back. It's 50 to 46 Navy.
Navy hasn't done a good job checking the Seahawks players off.
Navy's in a man-to-man again. Griffin for three. Rebound to Byron Hopkins, who's played well.
He sure has. With Liebert in foul trouble, you were wondering who they'd go to, but Pete Herman went to Hopkins, and he's responded with a nice game.
3 minutes left in the game as Fenton feeds Robinson, and he's fouled by Greg Bender. Fourth foul on Bender.
That looked like a harder foul than it was. Robinson was just a little bit off balance.
Carl Liebert is coming back in for Navy.
Here he gets fouled on the arm. A little acting of his own.
Liebert replaces Neil Fenton. Carl's been in foul trouble most of the game and has scored only 2 points after scoring in double figures the first two games of the tournament. Robinson is 4 for 6 at the free throw line. Of course, he's the man at UNC Wilmington. Will want a foul down the stretch. He's not a good free throw shooter.
Yeah, we've said that is the only weakness in his game, is that his free throw shooting should be above 50%.
Missed them both, but Hopkins grabs it. 3 minutes left in the game. A 4-point lead for Navy. Wojcik, Reese, looks into Robinson.
3 seconds. Been in there a while. Hopkins is trying to fight for position in here.
Nearly a turnover. Reese finally does pop it up, and Sandy Anderson grabs it. UNC Wilmington with a chance to cut the lead to 2 or to 1 if they get a three-pointer. Rousen pressured by Robinson. 2:25 left in the game. Tough pass into Anderson.
Pass and a terrific shot by Anderson. Really worked that two-man game very nicely.
Navy's lead is cut to 2, 50 to 48, 2:10 left in regulation. Robinson, Rousen trying to cut off the baseline, and we've got a foul against Greg Bender, and he's just fouled out.
Collins got three people on him here as he makes his move. Bender got in the way of the elbow, but he did foul him.
So Greg Bender has fouled out. At least we've got him for five. And that is his fifth.
Dick Vitale, John Long's guarding me, and I hear this guy screaming in the stands. Creamy can't go right. He can't go right. That's all he wants to do is shoot. He can't go right. And I looked over my left shoulder, and there's Dick Vitale. I couldn't believe it. I told him to come out and guard me.
And what did he say?
And Dick Vitale said, there's only two white guys, or there's only one white guy slower than you, and that's me. He said, I'd make you all pro, Greavy.
Ryan Rossum with his first career missed free throw against Navy, and it comes at a critical time. It was the front end of a 1-1. He could have given his team the lead. Navy is up by 151-50. 50 seconds left.
Navy trying to get the ball into David.
And he goes right to the basket, but there's Liebert. And a new 45-second count. Shot clock is off now, and all they have to do is hold it. UNC Wilmington is going to have to foul. But Navy will first call a timeout. Navy has one timeout left. UNC Wilmington with two remaining. That was a big missed free throw by Rousen.
It was. Rousen, who's had great success against Navy at the free throw line, missed that opportunity. And then on the other hand, that was the biggest offensive rebound Liebert's had in a long time, too. He kept that ball alive and gives them another possession, and now UNCW is going to have to foul. And you know Navy won't take a shot at the basket until they get either an uncontested layup. Just wait to make those free throws.
Navy has scored only 1 point the last 3 minutes and 20 seconds. So they've hit another of those routes that we've talked about. They're really going to have to guard against that in the NCAA tournament because they're going to be facing better teams than they've seen here.
But they're going to have to do that. They're going to have to just play more consistent. Rousen, you can see how upset he was after missing that free throw. And here we'll see Navy getting the ball to David Robinson, who loves the turnaround jumper. But there's Liebert, who's had a terrific tournament. He's my pick for on the all-conference team. Gets a great offensive rebound.
Seconds remaining in regulation. Navy leads 51-50. Cliff Reeves will inbound to Robinson. They got to foul him. He's the man they want to foul, but
yeah,
they don't go after him.
You're right. They had an opportunity, and you know, they will not throw the ball to David Robinson if they have to.
And now Robinson commits the foul. Robinson delivers an elbow, but they should have fouled him earlier. They wasted about 7 seconds.
I think David Robinson complained, in fact, that it was a flagrant foul. It should be a two-shot foul, but referees called a 1-1. And Robinson is a poor free throw shooter. I think Navy made a mistake by throwing the ball to him. They should have kept the ball in the hands of their best free throw shooters.
But Robinson could have fouled him as soon as he got the ball the first time. Shooting a 1-1. He's 5-for-10 at the line. He sinks a big one to put Navy up by two.
The All-American comes through. Not a very good free throw shooter, as we said before. There it is, a graphic 6-for-11. He needs to make this one.
He sinks two big ones. He's got 23, and Navy leads 53-50. A three-pointer that can tie it up. And the Seahawks will call a timeout. They have one left. The best three-point shooters on the team are Mark Gary, who's at 44%, but he's really struggled in this tournament. And Sandy Anderson, who's hit 44%. The only three-pointers that have been hit today by the Seahawks were by Rob Wagner and Ricky Griffin. Neither is in the game right now.
Well, there's going to be some strategy here. You know, the Seahawks can do really one of two things. They can either go solely at the three-point shot, try to tie the game up, down 3 points with 17 seconds, or they could take the best shot that they can get quickly and then foul Navy in return. Navy, who's not a particularly good free throw shooting team, that might be a pretty good thing to do.
Talk about Robinson's free throw difficulties. Reese is an 80% shooter. Liebert, 66%. Wojcik, 71%. Seconds remaining in the CAA championship game. Navy leading 53-50. Here's what happened on Saturday as East Carolina seemingly had UNC Wilmington down, but Brian Rousen hit his only three-pointer this year to win the game, and he banked it in.
And you see how fortunate they were to advance to the finals.
UNC Wilmington will put Ricky Griffin back in the game. He's a pretty good three-point shooter. He'll inbound. Craig Prather is in to pressure him. 17 seconds left.
See the free throw shooting.
That's been a big factor. Anderson with a three-pointer. Nobody picked him up. Rousen misses the chip shot on the follow. Gary tries to save it. Byron Hopkins is after it. Wojcik and Cherry go after it. And Cherry throws it away. Robinson's got it. The precious time ticking away. And Navy will win it. A wild ending to this championship game. And Sandy Anderson had a wide open three-pointer. Nobody picked him up. He just missed it. And Rousen missed an easy tip.
Well, they certainly had their chances. UNC Wilmington gave it their best. They had an opportunity to tie the game with that three-point miss. They played their hearts out.
Well, the two first-year head coaches, Robert McPherson and Pete Herman, and Navy wins it 53-50 as the Middies capture the championship for the CAA tournament. They win their 13th straight game and improve their record to 26-5. They also continue their dominance of North Carolina Wilmington. They are 8-0 against the Seahawks. Final score again, Navy 53, North Carolina Wilmington 50. We'll be right back.
March springs into action on Home Team Sports with a lineup that's full of variety and excitement. The Birds are back with three exhibition contests against the Yankees, Expos, and the defending American League champion Boston Red Sox. The Caps continue their push for the Stanley Cup.
Mel Proctor with Kevin Gravy back in Hampton, Virginia, as Navy has won the CAA Tournament Championship for the third consecutive year, led by David Robinson with 23 points in a strong defensive game. George Johnson is standing by with a winning head coach, Pete Herman of Navy. George?
Thank you, Mel. I am here with head coach Pete Herman. And Pete, this is a great way to finish the conference.
I'll tell you, these seniors deserve it. They've had a great year, and we got some very good performances from Byron Hopkins today, and Neil Fenton came in and made a big shot, and of course David making two free throws down the stretch. But we really did a great job on the defensive end, and that's what, you know, got us to win.
Want to talk a little bit about Manhurst, because you went with him. At first you hadn't. You put Hopkins in, I'm sorry, in the second half. And I wonder why you didn't go with Kerr.
Well, Byron played well against North Carolina Wilmington in the two regular season games, George. That's why we thought he'd be able to continue to play pretty well. He did a good job in both of those games. I want to give Bob McPherson and the Seahawks a lot of credit for a tremendous game. They have a great All-American in Brian. And it was just a good game for the conference.
Now, yesterday you had a big ball game against James Madison. And then in the first half today, it looked as if you were somewhat lethargic. Do you think that may have had something to do with it?
I don't know if we were lethargic. We missed like our first eight possessions, throwing the ball over the basket, and we seemed to be overpumped and wanted to do too much offensively instead of relaxing and making the easy shots. And that kept Wilmington in the game and allowed them to take a lead on us. We came back, got some composure second half, but it was tooth and nail all the way down.
I have a question I want to ask you real quick, and that is in the fact that you won this ball game today. You've been giving everybody credit, but you've done a heck of a job coming in. It must feel great, You had to pick up the pieces after Coach Evans left, went to Pittsburgh, and you must feel great.
It's an enjoyable job. The midshipmen are tremendous supporters. We have great parents and a great group of players. It was a very easy situation for me to come in because Paul had given me a lot of responsibility, and I'm very happy with the way things have gone up to this point, George.
Well, I really appreciate it. And go back to your team, and we're going to throw it to the public address announcer right now so that you can get the special presentations.
You're looking at the all-tournament team, which has been selected by the media covering this tournament. Brian Rousham of North Carolina Wilmington, Carl Liebert of Navy, Sandy Anderson of UNC Wilmington, Steve Krasser of Richmond, Eric Brent of James Madison, and the tournament most valuable player, David Robinson of the Naval Academy.
Well, no surprise there. David Robinson had a terrific tournament, carried his team to the championship.
Navy now 26-5 and headed for the NCAA tournament. There's Carl Liebert, who was in foul trouble most of today's game, but he had two terrific games.
Navy, number four.
Let's go now to the public address announcer for the presentation of the award.
Number 10, Doug Wojcik. Matt Nordman. Craig Prather. Bobby Jones. Derek Turner. Manhurts. Byron Hopkins. Rich Brennan. Carl Liebert. Rich Reynolds and David Robinson. Team captain for Navy, number 10, Doug Wojcik. Will accept the team trophy here from Commissioner Tom Yeager. Doug Rocha. There's the Colonial 1987 tournament banner. Awarded to the middies of Navy. CAA tournament champs going to the NCAA. You can tune in Sunday on CBS at 4:30 and find out just who these middies will play. Sunday at 4:30 on CBS when the NCAA tournament brackets are announced.
Tournament championship for the third consecutive year as they win their 13th straight game and are headed for the NCAA tournament. We will take a break and return with more activity from the CAA championships in just a moment.
Thank you.
Riggins with 10 reasons why it's time to order Field & Stream now.
One good reason is this tough, water-resistant duffel bag. It's one of two free gifts with your paid subscription. And here are nine more reasons. Field & Stream shows you how to get more out of fishing and hunting, thanks to the best outdoor writers in print. And right now, you can save plenty. 15 issues are just $12.97. That's 56% off the single copy price. You save over $16. So call 1-800...
You said two free gifts.
Okay, they'll give you the duffel bag plus a surprise gift.
A surprise? Like the
Ancient Super Bowl?
To order Field & Stream and get your free duffel bag plus the surprise gift, call 1-800-433-2700. 15 issues for $12.97. 56% off the cover price, 35% off the basic subscription rate. That's 1-800-433-2700. 1-800-433-2700. Call now.
The midshipmen of Navy are cutting down the nets here at the Hampton Coliseum as they celebrate winning the tournament championship with a 53-50 win over North Carolina Wilmington in the championship game. You see Ambrose Robinson, David's father, wearing the Navy hat. They let him cut down part of the net. And now David will get a piece of it. Byron Hopkins up there moment ago to cut it down. Here's Mr. Robinson, Ambrose Robinson.
He has much to do with this as anybody. He really supports their program, and he's almost at every game, I believe.
David's younger brother is also standing down. He may be able to see him. So look again at Mr. Robinson. David's younger brother is out there somewhere taking pictures with his Instamatic. There he is.
There he is.
He looks just like David. He's, I think... He's a freshman or a sophomore in high school, and Mr. Robinson said he's a better player at that stage than David was. Of course, David only played his senior year in high school and then really developed after he got to the Naval Academy. He grew 7 inches at Navy.
Yeah, what a story that is. But, his younger brother, he loves basketball, and of course, David is certainly setting an example for him. Probably a fine player in his own right.
Doug Wojcik wearing a net around his neck. His basketball career will be coming to an end. David Robinson's, of course, will continue in the NBA. And there's the winning coach, Pete Herman. Statistics on the championship game. Neither team shot well. Navy 43%, which was an improvement over the first half when they shot 32%. Free throws were a big key. NC Wilmington got to the line only 6 times. Brian Rousen missed a 1-1 in the final minute of the game. If he'd made both free throws, he could have put his team ahead because Navy hit one of those lulls late in the game and they went almost 4 minutes without a field goal.
Well, UNCW did have those opportunities to win the game or at least tie it. But they couldn't come through with any free throw shooting and missed that three-pointer.
Pete Herman in his first year as Navy's head coach, winning the tournament championship. He was a fine athlete himself, a basketball and baseball player at Geneseo State in New York. George Johnson is standing by with a couple of the minis, Carl Liebert and Doug Wojcik. So let's go to George.
Thanks very much, Mel, and I am standing with the captain of this team, Doug Wojcik, and also Carl Liebert. I don't want to leave you out, but I'm going to talk to Doug real quick. What a great victory for you guys today. It was tough. It was a hard battle.
Yeah, they really played us well. We wanted to get up on them early because they wanted to have a slow-paced game, kind of in the 60s type score. We always like to run the ball and get up in the 80s, but we couldn't seem to get up in the first half. Of course, we missed our first 8 shots or something like that, so we kind of got slowed there, and then at halftime, we were down by one. Came out, I think our defense won it for us, actually. We kind of slowed those guys down and stopped their outside shooting. And Dave did an excellent job on Brian Rousen, and we got going. Byron Hopkins did a good job for us. Kerry Manhurst did a good job, and then, of course, the big man did a good job, too. So we did well in the second half. First half was kind of shaky.
We've been talking all these past couple days about the fact that David Robinson was a one-man show in everybody's eyes, but you guys have proven lately that this team can come behind him and help him.
That's right. Well, you know, it's hard for people to see that there's other players out there because of David's so spectacular, but we're not used to playing without out. And the other night, it took us 3-4 minutes to get it at ease with ourselves, get it together. James Madison cut it to 7. We were a little worried, but once we got together, got in the rhythm, we came around and we widened the lead, in fact, with David out. So we play well together once we get used to playing together.
Carl, you said you took a seat for a long time. I'm telling you, you must have been sitting there. What was going through your mind?
I was trying to concentrate and stay in the flow of the game because I knew the coach put me back in. And I was really worried about, you know, coming in and being right in the flow and not slowing the team down and making a stupid mistake. And so that was what I was trying to concentrate on. And, you know, doing that, you know, by standing up and cheering, I guess it helped along the way.
We talked the other day. I just finished talking to Doug about the help. We've got to be happy with, first of all, in the first half, the way Carey played when you went down, and then the way Byron Hopkins played in the second half.
Definitely. You know, Carey played great in the first half, hit some big shots for us and kept us, you know, right in the game when we weren't playing so well. And Byron came in and really rebounded well for us, and then had a few little easy buckets around the lane to help out. But, you know, it's guys coming off the bench to help out, you know, like when I was in foul trouble, and have to be confident enough to have a guy down the bench that can come through for us.
I'll tell you, conference play-wise,